रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम, वेलकम टू अलीम अकेडमी। दिस इज़ बेसिकली क्वेश्चन नंबर 10 ऑफ एक्सरसाइज 3B एंड क्वेश्चन स्टेट स्टार्ट विदाउट यूजिंग अ कैलकुलेटर। इवेल्युएट दिस, वी हैव टू इवेल्युएट दिस एक्सप्रेशन विदाउट यूजिंग अ कैलकुलेटर। वी हैव टू डू दिस कैलकुलेशन विदाउट यूजिंग अ कैलकुलेटर। एंड देन व्हाट इज सेकेंड पार्ट, use a calculator to evaluate this. Then again we have to evaluate this by using a calculator. Do you get the same answer for 1 and 2? Then we have to explain our answer, that do we get the same answer for the part 1 and 2. Explain your answer. So let's start the solution. We make a small table for this. We are going to do the first part. The first part is without using a calculator, evaluate this. We have to evaluate this without using a calculator. Like, okay, let's do it in two steps. The first step is this, that you may follow BODMAS here. And BODMAS is bracket multiplication, addition and subtraction. So first we have to do addition, so let's add both of these numbers. Okay, so the rule for adding one number is with the decimal and one number is without decimal. The rules for adding these numbers is this, that we have to write them in the vertical form, and we have to use the decimal in place of decimal. And you know that one more thing that you should know is that 9876543 21, this number have no decimal. So where can be its decimal? Its decimal will be at the end of it. Its decimal will be here after the number 1. Okay, so let's do it. The second number, let's first put the first number 9876543 21, and then we use the decimal, and then let's suppose we write this number in this shape, because you know very well that let's suppose you buy something from market, and you buy the thing for let's suppose you buy the thing for $75. Then how do they give the receipt? The receipt shows that you have paid 75.00. You do not pay them $7,500. You pay them only $75. It means that 75 can be written in two ways. One is this, and the second one is this. So simple is that we can put as many as decimals we want. Sorry, we can put as many as zeros we want after the decimal. Okay, so we can put maximum number of zeros after the decimal, as many as we needed. So we can write zeros here. 0, then 0, then 0, then 0, then 0, then 0, then 0. And remember that every number has decimal. If it does not show the decimal, or there are no digits after the decimal, then the number will have decimal at the end. Means that the number will have decimal at the end of it. Like this number has the decimal after 1. But actually it does not have decimal. Okay, now we write the other number here. In the line of decimal, the decimal will come. Both decimal will come in single line. 0, 0, 0, then decimal. Okay, and then 0 here. See, there are 5 zeros before 7. Okay, now we add them. The operation that what we have to do, we write here. So we need to plus them. 7 plus 0 comes 7, 0 plus 0 is 0, 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 0 plus 0 is 0. Decimal and decimal will be a decimal. Like in place of decimal, we always have to write decimal. 1 plus 0 becomes 1, 2, will come, as it is 3 will come, as it is 4 will come, as it is 5 will come, as it is 6 will come, as it is 7, then 8 and then 9. Oh, sorry. 9. Okay, so this is the answer that is coming after adding these two numbers. So now what to do? We make another table here. We just copy this table. Copy and then paste here. Okay, and then we erase this data from this table. So what we have to do now, we have to subtract this number from this answer. Okay, we have to subtract this number from this answer. So what to do? Let's do it. We just write this number over here. Okay, and then we write the sign that we have to do. We have to subtract, so we write the minus sign here. And now write the other number, 9876543211. There is no decimal, so decimal will be after 1. So this number will come here in these boxes. Okay, like this. Then we can write decimal, and then we can write as many zeros as we need. Okay, now we write the answer. 7 minus 0 is 7, 0 minus 0 is 0, 0 minus 0 is 0, 0 minus 0 is 0, 0, 0. And decimal, 1 minus 1 is 0, 2 minus 2 is 0, 3 minus 3 is 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. So the answer that we are getting is this. We just write down the answer here. Oh, sorry. We have to write just the answer. Okay, so the answer will be 0.000007. We can write in this form also. Like unit, 10, 100, 1000, 10,000, 100,000. Okay, so we have write down the answer that we are getting after solving the first part without calculator. Okay, now see that when you will do the second part says that do the same calculation. Okay, use a calculator to evaluate this. Like we have to do the same calculation by a calculator. So what will happen when you will do it by a calculator? You will get your answer as 0. We explain it later how we get 0. Okay, then the third part. Third part says that do you get the same answer for 1 and 2? No, we do not get the same answer. So right here, no, we do not get the same answer. Then explain your answer. So right here, explanation. So we have to explain our answer. Basically, what happens that all the calculators that we use, they give us a result from 0 to 9 digits. They do not show us the digits after 9th digits. So what happens that all the digits that are coming after 9, they are just invisible for us. So the answer that comes on the screen, that will be 0. Okay, like it is coming in the second part. So 0, but in the first part we are getting 0.000007, but in the second part we are getting 0. We are getting 0 in the second part only because of calculator. Okay, so you have to write the reason here. The explanation will be all calculators give us result from 0 0 to 9 digits. We make this number more clear for you. Okay, 0 to 9 digits. So the digits which will come after 9, they will be invisible for us. Okay, those digits will be invisible for us. That is why a calculator will give us the result as 0 in the second part. That's it. This is the reason that because calculators are fixed from 0 to 9 digits, that's why we are getting these results. And so the part 1 and part 2 are giving us different results, and this is the explanation why they are giving us different results. So this was a very important question, and these kind of questions come in O-levels papers especially, and sometimes these kind of questions also come in examinations like GAT, GRE, NTS. These kind of examinations also give you these kind of questions. If you are new on our channel, then please subscribe our channel. It will be appreciation from your side that we will feel prayer if you subscribe our channel and watch our videos. So thank you very much for your precious time.